First of all, it's good to see you.
Yeah.
What's new with you? What's going on with you right now?
Well, you know, my family, we're growing. You know, the baby number 5 is in the belly, so that's exciting. So I've been playing a lot of Mr. Mom at the house, but then at the same time, I'm still, you know, getting this book promoted and really talking about how the walk is actually possible. You know, and that's what the book's about. So it's I'm having a good time right now.
Now, the interesting thing, the title of your book is The Walk. And in lieu of that, you've been in the league for, you know, close to 10 years.
Yeah.
As a running back, premier running back. And a lot of our viewers don't, a lot of people don't understand how difficult it is being a Christian athlete in professional sports. Talk about the challenges that athletes face being Christian athletes, especially as men, Christian athletes. And then how you were able to stand firm.
Well, I think the biggest thing with the Christian athletes is, you know, because I believe the same for everybody is a stance is a stance. If you're going to walk it out, you got to actually just choose and give it all to God. But I think the life that is in the NFL or in any kind of famous atmosphere, acting, sports, baseball, whatever, is that it goes so fast. There's, you know, you have everybody pulling at you for time, money, conversations, you know, relationships. So sometimes people kind of stick it in, well, is it a lust thing or is it a pride thing? And sometimes it's just all of it together pulls at you so hard that it takes a good group of people that you can be humble with, that you can actually share with you some of the deep things that are going on with you. Otherwise, most guys don't make it.
Yeah, so what you're saying is it's important to have a group around you, a support system, depending on what team you're with,
right?
You know, to help you, kind of iron sharpening iron type deal.
Yeah, you know, it's really funny. It's because I believe everybody has a posse. You know,
right.
The problem with everybody is what's your posse carrying? You know, if they carrying the Holy Spirit and some Bibles and some true love for you,
right,
you're gonna make it. If they're carrying some shenanigans and some selfishness, then you usually don't. Mm. And so everybody has to pick their friends well.
Mm, very important. Let me ask you this now. Looking back over your career, what's the one lesson the Lord has shown you that stands out to you?
You know, I was actually talking with my wife about this the other day. I believe that, you know, since I was saved at such a young age, but I came from a broken home. My dad was not there. You know, my parents were divorced at, you know, 9, 10 years old. So there was always this thing of wanting to prove myself. But how does the Christian kid who doesn't drink and doesn't do drugs and doesn't sleep around, how does he try to prove himself? Well, for me, you know, just sharing between brothers here, you know, for me, I would lean towards, well, I was so talented at football, I could be smart aleck or arrogant or cocky, and that would be the way to show my manhood. Well, you're not going to tell me what to do, coach, because I'll still make this next play a big run. Or oh, you think you're cool, but really your family's coming to watch me play. You know, so I knew how to be arrogant with the gifts I had. And God just really taught me that a real man can lean on God in every situation, every area. You don't have to try to fight your battles to prove your manhood. A real man has everything leaning on God, depends totally 100% on God. So I think that's the greatest lesson I learned is that, you know, God, when you give your life to Him, He will take all that you have.
Man, I hope a lot of young boys hear that message right there, man. Oh boy, where's my son at? You know. looking back over your career, do you have any regrets whatsoever?
Well, yeah, it kind of goes along with that. You know what I mean? You know, I wish I, you know, everybody would say, well, man, Shaun Zander, great godly man, loves people. Yeah, but there was definitely situations where I was like, ooh, you know what? I wasn't as humble and as loving as I could have been. And, you know, so I wish I could have had those situations back. But on the field, very thankful, very honored of the touchdowns and the records and things like that. But I would say off the field, you know what I mean? And I think for every person, if you look in the mirror, you got to be much harder on yourself than other people. So, you know, with people probably be like, what are you talking about, Shaun? My teammates and all that. But there could be one or two that could say, oh, no, Shaun, yeah, you know what, you did kind of not talk to me, you know, because I called the wrong play. Sorry, Coach Over. so that's just a true thing. But the coolest thing that I'm just realizing is that if you are hungry for God, He will keep on showing you His heart, your heart. and he'll show you how to keep on walking it out. And that's the joy of this journey, the joy of this walk.
All right. Two football questions.
Let me have
them. Now, it's been long debated who's the top running back in the league right now. From a running back, you know, former MVP of the league, who's the top running back in your opinion? 2010 season.
This is good. You know, this is a very good question because there's some young guys that have a lot of talent that you see, ooh, this guy sparks, so he's got the goods to do something special. But when you play, you know, as long as I have, can we get one? Mm-hmm. But when you play like I have and you've got, you know, but when you've played as long as I have and you've got a good, you know, I had that 5-year span, that's half a decade just dominating, you kind of always say, well, who can do it for that much? You know, it kind of goes back and forth. Right now, I really like the Rams running back, Steven Jackson. Mm-hmm. He's big, he's fast, he's strong, he can catch, he can do it all. So I kind of lean towards him. Adrian Peterson, everybody knows, is super talented. I don't know. You know what I mean? I don't know if I really think that he would be amazing for, you know, for a long time, you know, as well as long as Steven Jackson. My boy LaDainian is still ripping it up.
Yes,
you know
he is. I mean?
You know,
yes,
he makes me go stretch and get my cleats back out, you know. Yes, I'd hang with Steven Jackson.
All right, last question. Super Bowl 2011. If you had to pick three teams off the cuff. That's right, Shaun, you're on the spot. Off the cuff. You know, we're in week 5, just passed. We're going to week 6. Give me these two or three teams you think are fighting right now, have a chance to win it all.
I would say I love the Jets. They look very dominant. They play defense. They run the ball. That's how you win, you know. So with that, the Ravens fit that mold. And so I think that's the AFC Championship. Now, on the other side, the NFC, it looks crazy, you know, because you have teams playing great defense with no offense, or you got teams playing great offense with no defense.
Certainly.
And so, you know, with that, I'm going to hold my tongue on who's going to NFC.
All right. Well, you heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Shaun Brown, Shaun Alexander, and you're in the green room. Thanks, man.
Good stuff. Good stuff. Excellent.